everybody. Miss Jessica here from TeenHQ in TeenHQ, here to tell you all about some new teen reads. Today I have four pretty random books, but most of them I've read recently. I'm gonna start off with The June Boys by Court Stevens, and it is about the Gemini killer. Well, he's not so much a killer. He or she kidnaps three boys every year around June 1st and then keeps them for a year and lets them go. And they, during this time, have been fed, have been taken care of, but they have no idea who their captor is. And then one year, this year, Thea's, I think that's her name, her cousin gets kidnapped. And so it starts to hit really close to home. And then one of the boys ends up dead. So they tell you at the very beginning, this person could be anyone. It could be your mother, your brother, your aunt, your cousin, your neighbor. And Thea thinks that maybe this person is her father. He's a little crazy. So The June Boys, really good. I enjoyed it, especially if you like a little bit of true crime. And you should definitely check this one out. All right, book two I have today is one of our nonfiction books. It's called Your Brain Needs a Hug. And sometimes your brain does need a hug. This one is specifically written for teens with coping ideas and ways to deal with mental health stress, OCD, anxiety, anything that you might be dealing with, just being lonely. And I know that especially right now after the pandemic and then this summer, a lot of that can really mess with your brain. And sometimes your brain does need a hug. So check this one out. And we have lots of other books like this in our teen section. Book three I have is called You Should See Me in a Crown. And it is a really fun story. I got to listen to the author speak about it, Leah Johnson, last year. It's about a black girl living near Indianapolis, and she needs a scholarship for school, and a really good way for her to get a scholarship is to become the homecoming queen. So even though that's not her thing at all, she decides to give it a try. So it was a way for Leah Johnson to find the representation that she'd never seen for herself in young adult books when she was a teen. And it's definitely a fun read, especially because it takes place here in Indy. All right, and the last one I have for you today is called A Gift for a Ghost. It's a graphic novel by Borja Gonzalez. I think that's how you say the name. And it is a beautiful story. It's such simplistic, beautiful artwork that I loved so much as I was reading through, and I thought I could change the page way easier than I could, but the people don't have faces. It's just beautifully done, and I loved it so much. But it is about two different girls from two different centuries. One is in the 1800s and one is in 2016. And in 2016, the girl is a punk rock girl who wants to write her own lyrics and have a band. And in the 1800s, it's about this girl who loves the supernatural and thinks that she's seen ghosts, and she starts to write poems about those. And really, her mother just wants her to marry a man. And in 2016, her friends just want her to be normal. But their paths manage to cross, and I won't tell you how. By the end of the book, you discover what has happened and how their paths have crossed. But it is beautifully done, and I don't read a whole lot of graphic novels, but this one I really, really enjoyed, so you should give it a try. And I think that's all I have for today, but make sure you come check out the teen room here, TeenHQ. And if you have questions or want more recommendations, check out our website, www.greenwoodlibrary.us. Thanks, guys. Bye.